Hello everyone, welcome to soundproofguide.com. In this video, I'll talk to you about how to soundproof a wall in your home, office, or an apartment. With millions of people living next door to noisy neighbors, you might be wondering of ways to soundproof a wall. Soundproofing a wall in your home doesn't have to be expensive or complicated. In this guide, I will not only talk about how to soundproof a wall without removing the drywall, but will also explain ways to do it by removing the drywall and building something for better noise blocking. If you are doing the job on your own, please do your research extensively, as well as comprehend the items and soundproofing fundamentals. After that, by following these steps on the most effective ways to soundproof a wall, as well as using recommended soundproofing products, you can accomplish the desired outcome without blowing your budget. To make your house a bit quieter, you'll need to minimize vibrations, fill in sound leaks, and absorb sounds. So, let's begin with number one, fill in the holes and gaps. I figured I would begin with the easiest and cheapest method to soundproof a wall without having to break down walls. You can use this method if you live in an apartment where you're unable to alter the walls. Of course, you will need to crack fill around the window frames if you see any type of separations. Green glue noise proofing sealant is what I recommend because it not only blocks sound very well, but it also is very pliable, so it won't crack as it ages, letting noise through. If you're soundproofing a wall with no windows or doors, then you might think that you could skip this step. Well, think again. One place a lot of people wouldn't think of noise coming into a room is electrical outlets. Unscrew the cover of the electrical outlet and you will most likely see a significant gap between the box and the wall. All you need to do is fill in this gap with noise proofing sealant and you're done. Of course, if you're soundproofing an unfinished wall, then the best way to soundproof the electrical box is by completely wrapping it with a product called putty pad. Most people, however, will be soundproofing an existing wall, so the green glue is the cheap and easy way to go. You can also use the noise proofing sealant between the floor and baseboard if you see any sort of gap, that is. Most of the time you won't see a significant gap, but it only takes a minute to caulk this section of the wall and could easily decrease the noise transfer from the other room by a couple of decibels. Just a quick pause, if you like this type of content, consider subscribing to my channel. Also, if you have any soundproofing questions, leave me a comment and I will answer all of your questions. It does really help my channel by people leaving comments. Thank you very much. Number two on our list is double up the drywall. A popular way to soundproof an existing wall is by adding an extra layer of drywall over top the existing drywall. One crucial detail most people forget to mention is not to use the same type of drywall that is already there. Use a thicker 5/8 inch sheet of drywall for your second layer. 5/8 inch drywall will do a much better job at blocking the noise coming from the other side of the wall. Plus, it only costs a few dollars more, making it well worth the investment. Another essential tip when doubling up the drywall is to use green glue noise proofing compound between the two layers of drywall. All you need to do is spread the noise proofing compound liberally in a random pattern, so you're getting some all over the sheet of drywall. This is not actually glued, it's a compound that is specifically made to help absorb and block sound waves from passing through the wall. Don't mistake this with green glue noise proofing sealant. It is a different product. But let's be clear, this noise proofing compound is not a miracle noise blocker. It will, however, help reduce a few decibels of noise passing through the wall. For the cost of a couple of tubes, it is well worth the investment. Number three, mass loaded vinyl. Another way to soundproof a wall is by using a mass loaded vinyl. MLV comes in a roll, usually measuring 4 feet long. It's a very heavy and dense material, but also relatively thin. What you can do to make your wall even more soundproof when adding an extra layer of drywall and some green glue is by adding a layer of mass loaded vinyl on top of that, well, in between the drywall, of course. All you need to do is cut a layer of MLV the size of the wall you want to insulate and attach it on your existing wall before adding the second layer of drywall. You will see a significant decrease in sound coming through the other side of the wall with the MLV in place. Number four, resilient channel. Another great way to soundproof a wall is by using what is called a resilient channel. Most of the time, I would install this in a basement ceiling to eliminate footstep noise coming from above. But this can be added to a wall to improve soundproofing. Make sure that you install the resilient channel as suggested by the manufacturer to achieve the desired effect. I will have a link to a full article from soundproofguide.com in the description below on exactly how to install a resilient channel. I will also give you a small overview, so keep watching. Firstly, you need to remove the drywall, then apply the sound clips inside the joints and stud. Then screw the channel in the clips using drywall screws. Make sure that the screws only enter the web of the resilient channel and does not come into contact with the resilient channel base support. Do not over tighten the screws as they may tear through the metal channel. Now attach the second layer of drywall using proper longer screws. So basically that's the gist of it. Number 5, sound dampening paint. Yes, there is such a thing as sound dampening paint. Sound dampening paint or soundproofing paint is gaining popularity in the soundproofing industry due to its effectiveness versus cost and application. This paint is certainly not a miracle sound blocker, but it will decrease the noise coming through the wall by a few decibels. Make sure to apply 3 coats for best results. I have 2 articles going more in depth on one brand of noise dampening paint, and also one article and also a video on this channel talking about the effectiveness of this type of paint. Make sure to take a closer look at those articles and video to know if this is the right course of action for you. Number 6, a bookshelf. Let's say you need extra storage on top of soundproofing a wall in your home or office. Let's also say that you don't want to tear down the wall or add an extra layer of drywall. You could use a little known soundproofing hack by adding a bookshelf the entire length and height of the wall. By adding a bookshelf and then filling it up with books, you will be adding mass. This mass will do wonders in soundproofing the wall because you will be gaining an ample amount of storage at the same time. You can also add some cupboard doors if you don't have enough books to fill up the shelf. At least that way you won't be leaving any gaps where noise could get through a thin wall. Number 7, soundproof blankets or moving blankets. If you live in an apartment and are unable to alter the walls, hanging soundproof blankets could be an option. Of course, soundproofing blankets can be quite expensive because they are typically made in the shape of a doorway to use to soundproof a door. You would need to buy several of them to be able to soundproof an entire wall. A cheaper option would be to buy a bundle of moving blankets. Moving blankets are made of dense material and would help block noise. It won't be as good as an actual soundproof blanket, but it would cost you a fraction of the price, so it would certainly be something to look at. Whether you're soundproofing an existing wall or during construction, this guide should help you decide which way to go. If you're soundproofing a wall that has either a door or a window, then don't forget to check out my articles, How to Soundproof a Window and How to Soundproof a Door. The 2 articles also have a YouTube video tutorial, so make sure to give that a closer look if you need to add more soundproofing on a wall. So there you have it. Hope you found this information very useful. Please let us know in the comment section below what options you chose and how it's working for you. We would love to hear any new ideas that could potentially get the job done easier and also cheaper. Every item that I talked about in this video can be found in the description below as a link to either their website or an Amazon link, so you can easily find it and go buy it for yourself. Also, if you like this type of content, consider subscribing to our channel. We would love to have you as a subscriber. Having more subscribers, likes, and comments makes our channel more successful. So anything you can do to help us, we really appreciate it. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you next time.